Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Jane Jennings. This week, we take a look at Green Solution for Future Space Missions and find out what it is like to spend a year in space. But first, the latest flight is on its way to the International Space Station. The Progress 89 spacecraft is currently making its way to the space station, delivering nearly 3 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the Expedition 71 crew. The uncrewed spacecraft successfully launched from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan at 11:20 p.m. Eastern Time on Wednesday, August 14th. After a 2-day orbit journey to the space station, the spacecraft will then autonomously dock to the aft port of the Vesta module. NASA's live rendezvous and docking coverage will begin at 1 a.m. Eastern, with docking currently scheduled for 1:56 a.m. on Saturday, August 17th. Even in space, you can't escape yard work. The Advanced Plant Experiment 09, APEX-09, also known as C4 photosynthesis in space, observes carbon dioxide capture and mechanisms in 2 types of grasses. In this experiment, knowledge gained could support development of bioregenerative life support systems on future missions. Using carbon-metabolizing plants in life support systems also can help in the production of a critical life support product, oxygen. The 2 types of grasses in this experiment have evolved different methods of carbon capture. Researchers hope to learn how the unfamiliar environment of space impacts photosynthesis and plant metabolism. In some parts of the United States, school is back in session, so class, open up your laptops, we have a lesson for you.
I'm Jasmine McBelly, and today we're going to talk about cell organelles.
In this Classroom Connection episode of the NASA Educational Series Demonstrations, astronaut Jasmine McBelly takes students on a tour of the space station and compares the station's parts to the major organelles of a cell. Jasmine also shares how cells and microgravity help us better understand the human body and potentially help solve biomedical problems that occur on Earth and in space. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to spend a year aboard the space station? You can now hear from someone who did just that. On this week's episode of Houston We Have a Podcast, NASA astronaut Frank Rubio discusses his record-breaking mission to the International Space Station and back. Rubio was selected as a NASA astronaut in 2017. Launching to the space station on September 21, 2022, Rubio and his crewmates landed safely in Kazakhstan on September 23, 2023. Accumulating 371 days in space, this is currently the longest single space flight by a U.S. astronaut. Houston, We Have a Podcast is streaming now. You can find it on nasa.gov/podcast, Spotify, Apple Music, and SoundCloud. Or follow us on social media at NASA_Johnson for the latest updates. And that's Space to Ground for now. Thank you so much for watching.
Mark Kelly famously snuck the gorilla suit onto the International Space Station and scared his fellow astronauts. What's the pranking environment like? What does that look like for you?
Well, how about we demonstrate? So... so, as you can see, the pranking environment is strong up here, and kind of like it is a beautiful environment to work with. And as you can see, we have a lot of fun.